First of all, you'd have to set this up with two pseudorandom bit streams and do the same thing with the voltages, make them conversely. V low has a value and then zero here, just like you saw in the other example. And I could use the same timing variables, and I've set this to run at 1,000 times T bit, which is, if you recall, 1 over our data rate, and in this case it's 5 gigabits per second. And then you could use an I probe or our V positive and V negative to write an equation. And for the I probe, I don't want to check this box because in this case I want my transient output. Let me show you the results of this simulation. Here in the status window, you can see that it takes about 25 minutes. And here in the data display, you can see the results for transient. We have a similar I probe density plot. And then here's the equation using the front panel I diagram. And here you can see a comparison of the transient results to the channel simulation results. And while these I diagrams or density plots are similar, there's a big difference in the amount of simulation time and also the settings that are allowed with these transmitters and receivers. In this case, we have the 8B, 10B encoding available. So again, if it's linear, time invariant, and it's large and hierarchical, then you want to use the channel simulator because every time you make an adjustment, it's not going to be another 20, 30, 40 minutes to run the analysis, only a minute. And now let's move on to the final example, which shows how to tune taps with channel simulation. Here's a simple design named tuning, and the transmitter shows two post-cursor taps, T0 and T1, and those are set up here with variables, so we can tune these. I'm going to use the tuning icon, and with our density plot, you can see that by tuning either one of these taps, let's tune this one down and this one up, we can see that the density plot will begin to open the eye. There it is, and you can change the max and minimum values, and the height of the eye will change a little, and now it starts to open up. So that's the tuning design, and I suggest you try this yourself. Tune these two taps and look at the results for the channel. And this concludes our video on using the ADS Transient Convolution Simulator for eye closure problems for linear or nonlinear designs, or using the ADS Channel Simulator for linear time invariant systems. Thank you, and please contact your local representative for more information on using ADS for signal integrity analysis.